All right, we're going to shed some light on how to take a vintage item and make it new again, give it new life, new lights, and I mean that literally. Well, Shane Henry from Crooked Creek Farms is back to show us how to turn the unexpected into one-of-a-kind lamps. And I love these. I was just telling you, I really need to start paying attention because my house has no personality, and this is all personality
here. Yeah, we brought lots of personality on the show today.
So what are you looking for when you find an antique? I mean, like, how would you look at something like this, for example, and go, this could be a light fixture?
Yeah, so industrial's hot. We know that. We were using it all the time. This is a hood of a John Deere tractor. So put an Edison bulb in that, and you've just made some little boy's room iconic
vintage
for all his friends.
And fun.
Yeah, it's got a vintage feel.
Different.
It's metal. Exactly. It adds a new texture.
It probably cost you next to nothing to create. When
exactly.
you look at
when you
some
look
of the
at,
other
and
stuff
that's one of the our welder artists that did that for us.
But it's beautiful.
And then you can go total flip side of that and go from kind of to just funky fun. And that's one of the things that we did here with Lamp Lady.
Lamp Lady, is that what you call her?
Right,
She's got a name?
She's got a Venetian blind shade on her.
No way!
Yeah. It's just a really neat, took an old mannequin body, decoupaged some maps on it, and
you did this?
It. Yeah.
Oh, you're good. I love that. And so unique. Definitely
exactly.
would be a conversation
yes,
piece.
Yes, yeah. Nobody else is going to have that.
I'm sure.
It is not
it.
IKEA.
I love it. Okay, tell me about some of these other
ones. Yeah, some of these other things. Some of these other things we brought in. Old stoves and heaters are really great with mm-hmm. flickering lights inside of them, especially back to like a boys' room. If you need a nightlight, what a grown-up way to do a nightlight and not just have something plugged into the wall. If you can find old vintage, this is the old milk glass shade.
Okay.
These make great pendant drops and all sorts of, use what was a light piece that may have fallen apart. Mm-hmm. Use that piece and take it to a new level.
And do you need to be concerned about bulb size and stuff as you're thinking about
you
some of these fixtures?
If you are not experienced with electricity and wiring, get the concept together and get it to somebody who is.
Come call you.
Because you want something
come see
safe,
you.
Especially if you're going to put it in your child's room. And then just taking some of your everyday, like this would be an outdoor work light.
Yeah.
But again, how fun for a little boy's
room.
I love it. Yeah, and we did something really similar with that.
Okay, I love this. I saw this morning. I'm like, flashlights?
Yeah.
Really?
So flashlights drop from a pendant. Because they've got some weight on them, we used a flexi cord. And they just each have an individual bulb and turn on. And it's just a little, again, nightlight corner room pendant kind of swag you can do. Bird cages are great. Put an Edison bulb in that, wire an Edison bulb through, and you've got a really fun and funky
and different.
Piece
that it's can beautiful.
Sit anywhere. Yeah.
And that adds some greens to the room because sometimes
it's so
that's really
dark
hard.
Right now in January,
right.
Yeah.
Right. And then tell me about this one. This is really pretty.
Okay, so this is another pendant light. And what we did with this, it's a miner's can.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just ready to be over a kitchen sink or in a game room, over a bar. Again,
fun.
You can take any can and turn it into a pendant light with a simple, whether you use a bottle light kit, you can pick these up for like $6.
Right.
So if you want to do something like this or take it to somebody and have them mastermind that together for you.
Now this one, I saw it, I gravitated toward this one because I love me some sparkle, right?
Yeah.
And so tell me about what you did here.
So the candelabra, the reason that I brought it, because I didn't do anything other than we added a couple of extra drips of crystals because who doesn't need more bling?
Exactly.
I know, I got you. but the problem with the candelabra is the bulbs are really low.
Okay.
So by putting a vintage mirror behind that, wherever you're placing it in your house, you just went from 5 bulbs to 10.
Oh, I love that idea.
And it just adds an extra little pop to a corner of a room.
Okay, so tell me where I can start finding some of this stuff. If I'm thinking I want to be creative, where do I go to get some of these ideas?
Go to your flea markets. Go mm-hmm. to your outdoor garage sales. Do a crappy to happy segment.
Crappy to happy.
And you're going to find this kind of stuff that's just discarded. I picked that up for $2 at a garage sale.
And then what is this? Because this is beautiful. Did we talk about this?
No, we haven't.
Oh, my
these,
goodness.
If I find these, they're old floor plugs. So like your clip-on that you have now. That's not a new invention. These
right.
are, they have them. So I pick these up all the time, take them to my electrician, and have him rewire them for
me. And boy, this stuff is just such good quality and so beautiful.
You
they
don't
really,
get this anymore.
I mean, they don't have this at IKEA.
Yeah.
No.
This is
it's
not
beautiful.
IKEA.
And of course, tell us a little bit about your store and where people can find you.
Yeah, so Crooked Creek, we're in Waxahachie, and basically it is a Thursday through Sunday store. We go out, we pick all week long, and we just pile this 100-year-old house full of just fun and unique things.
I want to come with you.
Yeah.
I want to come with you one of these. And I hear there's a new coffee shop.
Yes, we got a new coffee shop. We opened up, and it's all decorated in this kind of feel. So just totally eclectic out in Waxahachie. Come out and see us just south of Dallas. It's worth the drive.
I love it. If you want some ideas, it's a great place to go for inspiration.
Thank you, Dawn.
All right, we got to do some more crappy to happy next time
you
come back.
I'm telling you.
I love that. All right, don't forget you can find these gorgeous vintage items and so many different varieties at Shane's Shop in Waxahachie. It's called Crooked Creek Farms. And get some coffee while you're down there.